Hi, this is Matt Miller from the Daily Call the News Foundation. Today I'm here with Bo Sales, a truck driver from Florida. So Mr. Sales, we want to know how is the current situation with the coronavirus affecting the truck driving industry? Or how is it affecting you personally?
Well, business is a little slower. It's not moving as fast as it has in the past. Our number one concern, we get products from point A to point B. We still have to stop and buy diesel fuel. We stay at a hotel every night. So we still need to be able to rely on the hotel chains to be able to provide us a place to sleep and safety. We have to buy diesel fuel, so we rely still on the truck stops to still be available, which hasn't been an issue so far. Minor things that affected that. Our biggest concern is to me is I fly back home once I deliver the product. I don't actually drive a truck back home, so I need to be able to. I rely on the airline ticket. If I do something, say 500-600 miles from Florida, then I could easily drive home. But if I went to, you know, Texas or California or another state that's too far to really to drive reasonably, then I have to rely on the airlines to get me back to my home.
Are you going to airports during this time?
Yes, I have. I'm still going through airports there. I was in Baltimore last week. It is much, much slower. You know, I look at it as a positive because when I get on a plane, I was on a plane the other day, there was 22 people out of 143 that the plane holds. It was really kind of nice because you could spread out and you didn't have to be crowded. But at the same time, I feel sorry for the airlines because I know they need to have the plane full to make money. I didn't realize that.
Yeah. So, you know, also airports right now, I was just thinking like they're the hot spots for the spread of the disease, you know, like, so are you taking, just in general, are you guys taking any precautions against the virus or anything like that? Are you guys doing anything differently now on your day to day to protect yourselves?
Well, I mean, yes and no. I mean, I'm not like, you know, wearing gloves and masks when I drive down the road. I'm in a truck by myself, so I'm safe in that standpoint. I don't, you know, when I go into the restrooms, obviously I wash my hands when I pump fuel and touching a diesel nozzle, or if I go to the restroom, or if I get a coffee cup or something like that there, you know, I'm washing my hands. You know, when I go to the airports, I try to find a place that's, you know, a little more, not as crowded. So I'm not sitting on top of people, you know, but taking the basic precautions. I know I haven't wore a mask when I go through the airport. You know, I do respect other people. I don't stand on top of them when we're boarding on the planes and things. For that matter, like I said, I guess that's an answer of a yes and a no. I am precautious, but I'm not, you know, being over cautious at the same time. That's the wrong way maybe to look at it.
Why is your industry right now so important? Why is it so critical? The transportation industry, you know, at this time where the whole world is locked down, basically. If you can like speak to that, like how the rest of the world's kind of depending on you guys in the transportation industry to keep things going.
Well, biggest thing is, I mean, I'm in the transportation industry, and pretty much everything you get, no matter what it is in the world today, is delivered by a truck. Even if it comes from a ship from another country, once it gets to that port, it still has to be put on a truck. You know, we're aware of the big toilet paper crisis. All that toilet paper gets to the grocery store, regardless of who the grocery store is, by a truck. They don't drop it in with an airplane. So, you know, trucking industry has got to be able to move products, whether it's medications. If we get a cure for this, that cure is going to be delivered by a truck. Somehow it's going to be delivered from point A to point B. You know, so we rely on that. I believe every I guess you could say thing that runs in America is run by a truck. I mean, the airlines, you know, if they don't get parts for them airplanes, you know, they can't fly, you know, a person from point A to point B if they don't get the part. You know, you and I are sitting here talking. You know, we rely on, you know, the internet, you know, to be able to get us to communicate with each other. The internet is kept in control by people, which in my opinion still relies on trucks, because they have to keep the equipment, the tablet that I'm talking to you on was delivered by a truck.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
But I do believe transportation is a very, very vital backbone to this country. I know a lot of times truck drivers get the bad name, we've seen the movies where it's just an old, a fat guy, driving a truck and dirty or whatever. And I don't really see that in the world today. I mean, most of us are clean. We do have rules we have to follow. The DOT requires us to do things. So, it's a profession that's always going to be there. I don't think no matter what the world, how it turns, you're always going to need to rely on transportation of one way or another.
Yeah, absolutely. And then lastly, I guess, so for the foreseeable future, do you think you guys are going to remain at work doing what you're doing? Because right now you're working through everything. You're working through the quarantines and all that. As far as you know, do you know if they're going to start to scale back your hours or force you guys to stop working at some point?
Well, we don't really work a 40-hour week like most of America. I transport products. When I need to go, I go. DOT mm-hmm. allows me to drive so many hours a day. With that said, it's essential. We're essential part. So we have to, the product that we actually deliver, the vehicles, they're used to keep, America running. So they're going to have to keep that moving. Now we normally go into Canada. I've been to every state in the United States except for Alaska, Hawaii, and Maine. We have dealerships in pretty much every state that we go to or drive through that state. We go into Canada. We do not go into Mexico. We'll deliver to the border. They have other companies that go down there for safety reasons. Right now, they say that the border has been shut down for non-essentials. I haven't been requested to take one to Canada, so I don't know how that works. I do know here in Florida, we have our governor has made it where that anybody that goes into New Jersey or New York State is required, if they fly back into Florida, they're required a 14-day quarantine. We delivered to New York and New Jersey. I was in New York, 2 weeks ago. So that wasn't in effect then. I feel perfectly fine. If I felt that I had the virus, I would go get checked, but I definitely do not want to endanger anyone else. But for our business constantly running, I believe, yes, it will stay running. Like I said, we're a key to the product that we actually deliver. It has to go on. It's kind of like electricity. If electricity went out, the world, it would be difficult to do anything. We couldn't even make a cure, I don't think, without electricity, because you got to have, refrigerators and things like that. So yeah. What we delivered, will it be impacted by, we may have to take extra precautions and do things? Yes, I think that may happen. I hope it doesn't affect us. As of right now, we haven't been affected too much. It's been a little slower. But other than being a little bit slower, it gives me a little bit of time to be home with my family too. So it's positive on that. One of my concerns is when I do travel, I haven't had to run into it yet. But when we travel, we have to stay at a hotel. We have to get food. Now, a lot of times I'll go to a KFC or I don't want to mention a restaurant really. But regardless of what fast food chain I go to, I usually go in there, I'll grab me something to eat, I'll go to the hotel, kind of sit back and relax. With the restaurants being shut, or not the restaurant, but where the restaurants being shut down where you can't walk inside, you can do a drive-through, I feel something needs to be addressed. Now, I have read some things online, I don't know how true it is, where they're allowing, some people are, coming out and taking the orders of truck drivers. I mean, they're traveling, they're away from their families, we still need to eat. Just like everybody else. So I don't know how they can, if I were to pull up into a fast food restaurant and they see my truck and they say, hey, we'll go to the door and take his order because we realize he's under, he's too tall to fit through our drive-thru. He's not going to be able to fit through there and order. That's something that's really concerned me because, if they shut that down, then how can I eat? I mean, I can't pack a lunch for 3 or 4 days while I'm gone. It's not feasible. So that's something that it's small, but I think it needs to be addressed for the transportation industry.